Good morning, I'm Madam Eileen. Today I want to show you how to make a quail. This is the quail. I've put it on a candy cup. Have you heard about candy cups? Candy cups are a great way if you want to give a wonderful balloon creation to your guests and give them a cup that holds candy. So that's what a candy cup is. I deliver them for birthdays, for special occasions, graduations. They can be a lot of fun. Let's see. There's so many different ways to do the graduation hat. I'm thinking, which is the best way to show you? So anyways, on with the bird. I'm going to have a list of the balloons you're going to need in the comment section below. So scroll down and read. I'll just get started. I'm going to take a black 260. I'm going to make the top of my bird so I figure out how much I want to use for the top notch, and I cut the black section off. I pull and tug to stretch out the balloon. This also creates a weak spot in the balloon, so when I inflate it, it inflates first. I'm going to take my electric inflator, put the balloon on. I'm going to wrap my hand around the balloon. And I'm going to give a little puff of air if it was turned on. Turned on now. So there's our top notch. Tie a knot at the bottom. Now you can do a little bit of shaping. You can pinch it, pull it, and force the air into just that one section to create that angle. Now our bird is going to be gray. I'm going to use my Hilbert, my large inflator, to inflate 2/3 of this balloon. Knot it. Now I'm going to take the top notch, I'm going to put it in, and then angle it to the side. What I want is I want one side, basically you're creating a two-way twist. I want one side smaller than the other. And we should have a smaller side towards the direction that our top notch is in. And then from here I get a scrap. And I tie just above the knot that I've caught. You want to make sure this is tied on before you let it go, or else it will all fall apart. Now you can cut and trim the extra pieces of that scrap off. Now you want to get the body of your bird. You could have wrapped this around that knot, but I didn't want to take the chances. If you don't want to rip your balloon off, you can squeeze the air out of a section, cut it, save this for later, and then I put my thumb down. I wrap the remainder of this balloon around my thumb, back to my thumb, and I pull the thumb through this loop. That's just an extra way to make sure that this part is secure. It's not going to leak air. Now you're going to take the rest of the black that you have. We are going to do three. Oh, of course. Forgot, I cut the end off. There we go. Tie a knot. We're we're going to do a bubble, great pinch twist, and then we're going to wrap around. So, inflate the air that the pinch string needs. Can I give a squeeze to make it soft? This first part is going to be the beak. And now we're going to do the three pinch twists. I find three just covers more of the joint. Two works really good, but I'm thinking three would work better. So in this demonstration, I am doing three pinch twists. Alright, from here I can try to make the beak pointy by rolling the knot. Rolling the knot means if you do the knot loose, then you can usually pull it and it'll move a little bit. That's just trying to make that beak a little more pointy. I'm going to go ahead and cut the nozzle off. Squeeze this, make sure it's nice and soft. Hold this in front of where the top notch is pointed. Around some of the pinch twists just to make sure that it is firmly attached. Pull it off. And to make this disappear, I pull and let go. And it beats down in there. Now it's just a matter of arranging these pinch twists. Two on top, or do I want two on the bottom? This is where arch comes into play. You know what? I think I'm going to do two on the bottom. Yeah, two on the bottom, that way I can point the beak more down. Alright, from here, let's do the wings next before I finish. We're going to finish the eye. You're going to take your 1/16 round. For most. We're not putting any twists in this one. We're just going to be putting it around the head twice. I'm going to take this, the 1/16 by the knot, and I'm going to go around one of the pinch twists and in. Go around the bottom. Now if I just go around, it might stick out a little bit. I want it to be even, so I'm going to push the black up a little bit as I wrap around. Now I'm going to pinch and roll right underneath the pinch twist of the beak. Squeeze so it's soft. I'm going to pinch and pull. Try to get that section of the balloon narrow. Now I'm going to wrap it around full length. And then about the part that it went narrow here, I'm going to pinch, pull, and slowly let air back into that section. Pinch the narrow section of that balloon and go around the beak. And you never know when you need some more balloons, so I'm going to let some air out. Just so this piece has a long tail. So this is a just-in-case balloon. So you can see what a difference by pulling the air out and then just letting a pinch in. Creates a wonderful shape on the head. I'm thinking maybe I should have done that on the bottom. But balloons But I'm gonna lift the black, and I'm gonna cut the brown underneath. That also makes it look like it's narrow at the top. So tucking is a good way to create that illusion of narrowness. Now, I see the brown sticking out of here from the beak. I don't want that, so I'm going to try to pull it towards the back a little bit more. Pull it and let it go. Alright, 260 brown's the next. This balloon is going to get a lot of width. There's going to be at least 8 twists in this balloon. So you want to try to have an 8-finger tail. If it's shorter, then you may have to get another balloon. Also, I want to make it longer and thinner. So I'm going to pinch this top, grab here, and pull. This thins the balloon a little bit, but it also increases its length without losing too much of the tail. You can do that 2 or 3 times. Do it too much, I think it could pop because you're creating heat and friction. The first thing I want to do is the pinch twist. We're going to make the wings of the bird now. So there's pinch twist. And 4 fingers spread out. You want to do 1 section long and 1 section just a tiny smooth short. So I'm comparing to my first bird. That looks like a good top. Now I'm doing a tiny spacer bubble. A spacer bubble is the distance between this joint and the joint of another balloon if it should be underneath it. Now I'm going to do a pinch twist. Now this next balloon is going to be just a tiny shorter than this balloon. To make sure you have your proportions correct, you don't just go by fingers. You want to look at what you have, compare what you're doing to your creation. Does that fit? It does. Quails don't have very long wings. Now I'm going to twist these 2 sections together. So you see how the spacer bubble? It's just barely a finger wide. But it's just enough to bridge the gap from this joint to this joint of these 2 balloon sections. And now we are going to close these together with no space. Like that. You put the larger one on top. We're going to thread this through this loop. It's going to stick out, but we're going to do something that pulls it in to the back. And you want a gap. We're going to be putting another balloon around here. And so you want to, a 1/60 gray is going to go around. So you want to make sure you have at least a thumb's width space between the loop and the wing. Give that space, same space on the other side. Do your pinch twist. Since they're on 2 sides of the bird, people won't notice if one side is slightly bigger than the other. But I still try to make an effort of 4 fingers, 1 slightly spaced over, 4 fingers, 1 slightly spaced over, to start the next wing. To make your balloon look good, it's not about measuring per se, but proportion. If your balloon inflates slightly bigger than mine, you'll have a different outcome. If it inflates thinner, again, slightly different. So, I did the long one first, and then I did the short one. You could also do the short one first, and then the long one. These are commutative. These do change around. And that's all we need of the mocha brown. After you go around this pinch twist a few times, you can go ahead and break and tie this piece off. I'm wrapping around my thumb, catching the end, and then rolling the knot off my thumb, eating the end of the balloon. That's just my way of making sure it's doubly secured and it's not going to pop off. If you're speed twisting, just wrap it around several times. It'll hold just fine. Okay. Now, before I close the wings, I'm going to do the feet. So you need your 160 gray. This quail is known as a gambles quail. The coloring of this one is more towards the female of the species. I live in Arizona, and you can often see quail running about in the quieter parts of town. Okay. We are going to take the feet, so you want about two fingers, and then a pinch of this, and then three fingers, and then connect the two. That's the 1 foot. Arrange it so the pinch twist on that is on the outside. You have your two long bubbles here and your one short bubble here sticking out. That's the back of the foot. We're going to be going up and around and going down here later. So it's okay if this gets out of place. It'll go back into place once we're all done. Now we do the spacer bubble. This is a long spacer bubble because it's between feet and it needs to span the 3 inches of the 350 by just a little bit. So you don't want to put this 3 inches across. This is going to take up some of the space. Now from here, I do a pinch twist. I do 3 fingers out, 3 fingers in, twisted in. Now we're going to go through the bird. The feet are very close to the body on a quail. So that's how tight you want it. Now you might say the feet are pointing backwards. You put it on wrong. Well, I'll show you how to fix your backwards feet in just a little bit. I have to finish connecting. The feet. And now, this foot needs that back toe. You can pull this out into a string, or you can just go across. I pulled the air out of the section, and I'm pulling it across and wrapping it around that pinch twist, moving the pinch twist to the side of the foot, measuring 2 fingers. Now this part, plate, tie, pinch. Let go of the air, tie your knot, pull it, roll that knot so it's tight, snip the excess. Now this is how we turn the feet the correct direction. Just you grab and twist. Just twist it around. Rearrange that pinch twist so the toe sticks out back. And make sure the toe's twisting back out here. Okay, now we're ready to finish the wings. Let's see, I had a 160 gray. Okay, take another 160 gray. You want to put 3-finger bubble, attach it here at the top of the wing, arrange it so the 160 gray is on top and on the bottom of the pinch twist. Now we go around the wing. And we twist off a bubble and join the joint to the bottom pinch twist. going to do the tail of the quail. We're going to go over 1.5 fingers or 2 fingers. Do a pinch twist. Give a squeeze here. Now the tail, you want to go a fistful up, match it back down. Do 1.5 fingers or 2 fingers. Check it. I'm thinking I do need one more pinch twist to hold that tail out where I want it. So I'm going to twist off a 1 finger bubble. Now that's a tight space to put another pinch twist against an existing pinch twist. So the way you get around it to make this into a pinch twist is I grab the joint, pull it in, pinch my long balloon to go under the first pinch twist, and then I roll my balloon around the first pinch twist, and voila, you end up with a second pinch twist. Now I do the 2 fingers and connect it to the small end, the small side of our mocha down on the other side. Going around once is okay if you're speed twisting, but if this is going to be a display piece, you might want to go around twice. Now the wings are connected and the tail is formed. With the 2 pinch twists there, it helps hold that tail out where I want it. Now we go around. We go around the wing. Pinch and roll the balloon around twice on the top pinch twist so the bottom sticks out. It almost looks perfect. I just need a little bit shorter. It's pushing really tight, so I'm going to put a kind of pinch a little bit of air out. I need a that scissors is or a tiny snip. I got it. Let just a pinch air out. Just so you have enough to tie a knot. This may fail. I get my loop, but getting this little piece through the loop is proving tricky. I may have to get a clap of 168 to finish my game. Oh no, I got it. Haha, I got it. Yay. But this game has ended up just a pinch bigger. And this game. Because they're 2 games, people won't look them at the same size. So they might not say, haha, one is longer than the other. People will rarely say that. They'll say, see one side, oh, neat. They'll see the other side, oh, that's great. Very few will critique you on the wingtip size. But if you're doing this for competition, yep, you want to get it perfect all over because other balloon artists will be watching it. Now there's a few more things we can do on detail that I didn't grab. So I'm going to go behind the curtain. I need 3 160 whites. Oh, my balloon case is far away. I am stretching, I am breaking, I am pulling. Ah, there it is. 1, 2, 3. 3. Now, because I'm not going to give this to anyone, I am using my mouth. Just a little puff of air. Cut just above the knot. But that's what I did. This is called puff inflation, where you just give a little puff of air to hold. A little more difficult to do this on an inflator. Alright, cut the ends off. Now we're going to add accents to our bird. I'm going to pinch and pull that knot out. I'm going to wrap it around the beak just one time. And then I'm going to just trace around the top of the bird. Like that. Now we're going to go and do the wing. I'm looking at my marble to see which way I went. There's several different ways you can decorate an accent. Bird. So I'm just wrapping this around the joints, just tracing the lines. Started on the up, and then end on the down. You tuck and you wedge it in so it's pressure fitted. It's held by the pressure of these two balloons pinching down together. I'm going to take my other one, wrap it around the top, and twisting that, place around, put my thumb in, wrap it around that front pinch twist, and then lay the balloon down to the back, wrap around the bottom pinch twist. Tuck the end under. It's loose fitting, so now I pinch and tuck so that line is fitted around. That's our quill. Our quill's not done yet. We're making a candy cup. Now I'm going to take a green 260 and we're going to make your regular petal. It can be a 5-petal flower or it can be a 6-petal flower, but you'll find that the flower makes a perfect base to rest a lot of your balloon decorations. Ah, my son has awoken. Hey son, I'm reminding you, today you have to finish that book for class. So go find your book. Ah, yes. This is what happens when you procrastinate and don't read your book or your book discussion. This is basics. I'm not really explaining how to do the flower base, except my advice is you want to keep the petal small. It's going on a cup. The cup is this wide, and so you want to make sure that the flower is just barely wider than the cup, but don't want to get too big. Some of these loops, I think, are a little too big to really do well on a candy cup, but as long as the petals are even, that is what matters. And let the air out. And now I'm just wrapping all the loops. I'm marking it around all the loops to get them together. And now I'm going to pull them apart and set them together. Pull these apart, set them back together. I'm ending up with that one loop up. I need to pull two of the loops apart and tuck this in. And that way they're all lined up. You can see this one's a little taller. I'm going to push it down and in towards the center. and that makes it look more even. All right, there's our base. We have a rubber band. I don't see the rubber band. So I will get another scrap. You want a scrap about the length of a rubber band, or in this case, I do have nothing. When choosing a scrap to attach the bird to the green base, some of this is going to be eaten up by being wrapped around the flower twice. So that little piece needs to be able to stretch nicely across the feet of the bird without being so tight it pulls the legs in. So I think that's too small. Here's a red 60 scrap. I think I'll use red because this is a teaching demo, and you can see how it goes. Just to help it start, I tie a knot at the end because I know that will definitely be held in. I take my thumb and I push the scrap of the balloon into the center of the flower. I pull the knot out and I go up and back over and I let go, and that's enough to hold the flower to the bird. Now I'm going to turn the bird upside down. I'm going to pull this, center the flower in between the feet. I'm going to go around one foot, go around the other foot, and go back to the center of the flower, and then go around once. And that's enough to hold the bird to the flower base. And from here, you can just arrange the toes how you want them on the base. Now I'm going to show you how I put the base on a candy cup. A candy cup is basically those Slurpee cups that your kids get. But you can buy those at a good restaurant store. And when you buy your cups and the lids, just because they are domed lids for 16-inch-ounce cups doesn't mean they will fit. In fact, if you buy at discount, often the lids do not fit the cup. So you might want to test and make sure that the lid, when you push down, clicks. All right, now what you want to do is you want to fill your cup with candy or cookies or crackers, whatever the person you're giving the cup to likes, you can put in the cup as long as it fits. So you can put your business card, you can put candy, cookies, mints. Just put some candy in. Just enough to give it a little bit of weight to hold down so the balloon just doesn't just blow over. And then you want to take a small round balloon. You want to add some air into the balloon. The balloon I'm using is a balloon that I thought everyone would be excited about, but no one likes it. So I use it for many of my practices. It's Thor, God of Thunder. For some reason, no one wants this balloon. So I have a whole bunch. Now, balloons are from the sap of the rubber tree. They are going to go bad. They are going to expire. So you want to use up old balloons before they expire and become useless. Then you have a waste of money. So I'm going to take Thor. He's fully inflated. I put the nozzle through the hole. And now I'm going to let air out while I push down. Not hearing that click. Why is that clicking? It clicked the first time. You guys saw it click. There, click. I am keeping a careful pinch and I'm pulling the excess of the balloon out of the cup, so when I tie a knot, it looks like that cup is fully filled with balloon and candy. And now, to attach the quail to the candy cup, you grab this by the knot, put the flour on top of that center, hook your thumb underneath the knot in the center of the cup, and then pull this up, and then pull it down. That's enough to hold it in place. You can do it one more time if you want to make sure it doesn't move. This toe still has a nozzle end, so I'm going to cut that off. This is where you clean up your design. You turn it around, you look to see this white is going a bit too much up. I'm going to tuck that, push and try to put that under a little bit more. Pull it out. And look at the back angle. Do a little adjustments. Make sure that the balloon is where I want it and not where the balloon has decided to go. Cute little tail. And that it is. We have our candy cup, our base, and our quail. A delicious treat to make a delivery. Oh, but there's one more thing to do to show you. But that'll be my next secret. I got a box. Tune into my next video and see what is in the box. Bye. I know, that's evil. Cliffhanger. Sorry.